One bad decision can make your life 36 times worse. In this video, I'm going to share with you 5 steps to more confident decision making. So if you want to make unwavering decisions, then perhaps you need to look at your decision making process. So I'm going to share with you 5 steps, but I'm also going to share with you 5 points to making better decisions. And you can apply these 5 points for every decision that you make in your life, whether it's big or small. So the first thing that you want to look at when you're making decisions is to think about how open-minded you are. You need to start off with an open mind, because if you're narrow, then you're not objective. And if you're not objective, it's like being in the jungle versus being in an airplane flying over the jungle. And you can actually see better and you can understand what the surrounding situation is, the terrain, if you will, and then you can make better decisions. So if you're trying to make better decisions, being objective is the first step. It's like going 30,000 feet out and then looking in. I do this all the time with people because they're too stuck in what they're trying to do and what they're trying to accomplish. They're too close to it. But I'm not, so then I can help them get objective perspective. So the first thing you want to do is to zoom out, get objective perspective, and then you can zoom back in and make a better decision. The second thing you want to do is make sure that you get all the facts. If you don't have all the facts, then how are you going to make a better decision? You know, if you're trying to get somebody to do something for you and you don't have all the facts, well, then guess what? You're not going to be able to persuade them very easily. You won't be able to get them to get motivated and do something. I mean, think about it. If you're a parent, try this with your children. How can you get them motivated if they're not even interested? You know, so you have to get all the facts first. You need to make sure that you collect all the data that you can, and then you can make an effective decision based on that data. We do it all the time with investments. We do it all the time with buying a house or a car. We collect all sorts of information, the specs, and we go so deep. But when it comes to making other decisions in life that we consider small or arbitrary, then we just make them irrationally and we don't get all the facts. But then they could compound and become 36 times worse. The next thing you want to make sure that you do is to make sure that you look at your future and predict it. There is a lot of psychology and brain science that shows that predicting our future has power because it has a pull. If we predict the future, then you're going to look at perhaps a compounding effect of your decisions. If you decide on something, how's that going to impact others? And then how are they going to impact others with their decisions? Is this going to have a ripple effect? And it often will, because if it involves other people, then you will see how it's going to impact them, but you'll see it after the fact. So if you go into the future, then you can look back and realize, if I say yes or no to this circumstance, what's that going to do? Recently, I had the opportunity of working with somebody. They were very intelligent and very, very academic, although they were very hesitant in their decision-making process. And because they're very hesitant, it would be very difficult for me to work with them. And so I made a decision not to work with them. Now, that means I'm not going to receive income potentially, but I am actually saying no to something that's lower value and yes to something that's higher value that isn't here right now, but that will be here in the near future, because I'm now opening a door. I closed one window and I open a door over here. So that's the other thing that you want to consider when you're making a decision is, do you have this future vision? The other thing is that you want to get opinions only from people that you really, really, really respect. People that you would even trade places with. Those kinds of people have opinions. Why? Because they're educated, they're intelligent. They may have tried what you're trying to accomplish. So ask those kinds of people, not just anybody, because there's opinions everywhere, and you can ask your friends and relatives and neighbors, and you don't want that. What you want is effective decision makers that have made decisions of this level, and then they can help you get to your ultimate decision, which is going to help you grow. Instead of going 36 times down, you're going to go 100 times up. And the last thing you want to do is take action. If you're not you know, if you're hesitant and you're not taking action, then what's going to happen is you're going to get caught in this feedback loop where you have to make a decision, but you hold back and then you don't move forward. I've had this happen to me time and time again. I remember being at an event. I went to the event. I listened to the speaker. They were a billionaire. They offered a program where I could learn and engage with them. And I made the decision not to, just because it was an investment and I didn't feel like I was going to get what I needed out of it. And after I left, I was getting some gas at a gas station and I was speaking with my wife, and she says that I always do that. I see an opportunity or an opportunity to engage with somebody, learn from somebody, and I don't invest. And right there and then I had the awakening, and I drove right back and I purchased their program and I invested, and I learned and I gained a lot from it. And that was a better decision. But it took her helping me to wake up. I had an opinion and then I took action on it. So now I'm going to share with you the 4-point decision-making process. I'm going to include a link below to a short video about that so you can see exactly what it is and you can take a screenshot of it and start applying it to your life. So the 4-point decision-making process is as follows. You have to ask yourself, do I want to do, be, or have this? Do I want to do, be, or have this? And it's a simple question, but when you ask that question, the RAS, which is the reticular activating system in your brain, is going to get activated, and it's going to start answering that question. It's going to look for the solutions or the resources to tell you, is this something that I want to do, be, or have? Do I really want it? Otherwise, you're not going to be motivated, and you'll waste your money and your time, if it's an investment of some kind, which I'm assuming it will be. The second thing that you want to do, second question you want to ask, will being, doing, or having this move me in the right direction of my goal? So if you have a goal in mind, great. Is it going to move you in that direction of that goal? Even beyond that, is there a bigger and broader goal? In my book, Living Life Your Dreams, I talk about reverse engineering your life from death backwards. So when you go from death backwards, you think about how you want to be remembered. So if people are remembering you for being kind and caring and diligent and resilient and forthright, then that's the kind of thing that you need to keep in mind when you're making a decision about a small goal, because it will impact your larger goal. And the other thing that you want to ask yourself is doing or being, doing, or having this thing that I'm deciding on going to go against God's laws or the universal laws? You may have a faith of some kind, or you may believe in higher power, but is it going to go against those laws? Is it going to impact those laws or those principles that you're living by, those standards? You all have standards that you're living by, so just think about what those are. And is it going to impact those? The last thing you want to ask yourself is, will being, doing, or having this goal that I'm going for, this decision I'm making, is it going to impact or violate the rights of others? And if it's going to impact other people, that's going to create a ripple. So these are the 4 questions you can ask yourself, and you should ask yourself every single time. I've made decisions that are as much as $25,000 and $100 and, you know, all over the, you know, the different ranges, and even $600,000 decisions based on using these 4 questions. And the way this works, and you'll see it in the video, is that you want to ask yourself these 4 questions, and then it make sure that you write them down. If you get a yes for the first one, a yes for the second one, a yes for the third one, and then a no for the last one, that's going to it won't violate other people, then make a decision and move forward. And once you take action, you will see it's either going to be the right direction or not. There's a great quote that we should trust in perfect timing. So if you trust in perfect timing, then you take action. And if it's not right, even if you said yes and you gave your credit card, if there was a payment involved, and then something happened, you know, it could be an illness or a problem with launching, with the program being started or something of that nature, or maybe it's a live event and they had to cancel, then you get your money back. But just trust in perfect timing. Trust that life is always working for you. You know, faith is being sure of what we hope for and certain of what we don't see. So why not have faith in the thing that you want and step forward? And if it's not right, it'll self-correct. I've seen this time and time again. Even that mastermind that I joined, $25,000 mastermind, the investment was high for me at the time, but then I said yes, And I didn't even get to attend 2 out of 3 events because my father-in-law was ill and then he eventually passed away. But I said yes, and I invested the time and energy, and now I can connect the dots because the things that I learned from that mastermind, I'm applying to my business and helping my clients apply the same practices and principles. So this is a 4-point decision-making process that you can make so that you make better decisions, and those will compound and you'll start seeing the impact of better decision-making. Fearless leaders in the world make better decisions. The ones that don't, they go down. We see this time and time again. It doesn't matter if it was Napoleon Bonaparte or anybody else. They made effective decisions, or if they made one bad one, everything went down. So this is Dan LeFave. If you enjoyed this video, let me know. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you on my next video. Enjoy the rest of your day.